where you get it out and then. Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Today is a very special day because we are expanding our gameplay again. As y'all seen last time we played, I played some Fears of Fathom at one point. Episode 1 had me on my toes, but just like I said before, I do this, I'm a gamer, so you can't judge me. It's time for us to go ahead and get into Fears of Fathom Episode 2. I'm excited to play this, and for those of y'all that don't know and is new to this, Fears of Fathom is based on true stories. True stories. Can't believe this. Devastating indeed. Devastating. But other than that, how's everybody doing? I hope everybody is well. Recently been trying to get back into working out again, mostly physical therapy. I got a bad shoulder, so I work on that as much as I can. I'm gonna see a doctor one day. You know, doing all that, listen to my favorite artist, Drake. You already know what it is. And my second favorite, Donald Glover, my idol. You know what it is. But anyway, let's go ahead and log it in and get in the mix. Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, you hear the audio. I can't guarantee your safety is going to be secured. So I suggest put on a seatbelt, grab onto the steering wheel, and get ready to lock it in, people. This is Fears of Fathom, Northwood Hitchhike. And I'll be damned if I lose somebody out here tonight. So let's go ahead and do this. Like I said before, these scary games do get me, but I think I'm toughing up a little bit. I played that Resident Evil game, as y'all seen, and like, I don't know, I feel, after playing that, I feel like I can play anything. Alright, let's get in the mix. This happened to me when I was 19. I'm a little over 21 now. I still remember this very clearly because of how creeped out I felt. I was a bit hesitant to write this out for the internet at first, but getting it out may help, even if it's just a little bit. I was one of those people that loves gaming conventions. Me too, dawg, me too, facts. I'd go to every convention I get the chance to. Sometimes even meet some of my online friends. Whew. Though my parents were always thrilled at the idea of me going on interstate drives, but a plane ticket would have been too expensive. This convention I was at went great, and it was now the day to drive back home. But when I set off, I soon realized traffic was horrible. Oh, now you already know what he's finna do. He's finna shortcut it. I decided that I'd take the long way to avoid traffic. What I say? You gotta be patient, though. That's horror tip. My bad. Horror tip number 389. Never take shortcuts. Only time you should be taking shortcuts if you know you can do it. Like, let's say jumping over a ditch. Like, let's be honest. You can jump over a ditch. But be clear, if you can't, don't try it. Cause you're gonna trip, and then you're gonna look back, and the killer's gonna be like this, and then you're gonna be down here doing this, wondering how you got here. And then they're gonna play back the music in your head, and all you have left to say is, well, I bet you wondering how I got here. Well, it all started at the gaming convention. Like, we're not doing that. It was a little over a 12-hour drive. So, through my horror gameplay, one thing you will notice about me is the saying that I live by.
The more you fuck around, the more you're gonna find out.
And I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm not trying to find out. So, yeah, we're gonna make sure we keep fuck around down here and find out way over there. Alright, I don't know what's playing, but can I turn that off? Driving at night is really therapeutic. Nice. Hey, another car. Loser! Oh man, I wish I could play some of my playlists. Y'all listen to on the drive home like this. on the night drive home, I like to listen to either a podcast or music. In terms of podcasts, I love listening to the Alt Dev Squad, man. Like Patrick, how do you not have gas? You didn't fill up before you left the gaming convention? You're halfway through the drive. I realized I was low on gas. Yeah, no dip. Well, I guess I'm assuming we're gonna stop at a gas station. Even though you're in the middle of nowhere, so there's probably none. But in terms of what I listen to, I be listening to, you know, All Dev Squad, Patrick Cloud. Ooh, Dad. Hold on. I don't feel like it. I'm not stopping. Patrick Cloud, to hear more, make Scoop and all them. And in terms of music, I got a nice little playlist because this is a track. Harlow. What's that? You already know, bro. I'm already getting nervous. Oh, perfect. Perfect. Look at that. Pull up right here. Thank you. But in terms of the list, too, Drake, Jack Harlow, Cordae, Jid. And then I also been listening to some like random people. I've been listening to random music a lot lately as well. I've been listening to some piano music. I've been listening to Mexican culture music. I've just been vibing all types of music lately. You know? I don't know why. Look at that. That's some orange juice. I want that too. And I want on gump pump. Hold on, you know what we gotta do. 1, 2, 3. That's the best 4. And I'm gonna need 40 on pump 4. Alright. We're only getting 10? Oh, that'd be fine. Ma'am. Hey, can I get 10 on pump 2? Yes, sir. I mean, I thought that was pump 4, but okay. You head into the bridge by yourself. What? What was that? Bro, can I exit? Can I exit this conversation? No. Whatever. The bridge? Northwood Valley Road, I mean. Not a lot of people head down there this time of year. Be careful. Yeah, what do you mean by that? For after a century now, many people have been going missing down there. Okay. And people who went looking for them never returned. Locals say the Norwood Valley monster had torn them up and hung them upside down on trees. Jesus. Can I use the toilet? It's not clean. Okay. Then clean it. Okay. Got pump too. Okay, thanks. I'm assuming I can take this with me, so. It's a guy. What? Anyway. I can't take it with me? Need to pay for that, ma'am. I said pump 4 and this. Oh my. I didn't want it anyway. And one more thing. Can you get out of the way? If you see a woman in a white or blue gown trying to get a ride, do not stop. Who is she? Some people say that she died in the car accident there on prom night. Some say that she seeks vengeance after she was murdered. Regardless, she is out for blood. Whatever you do, never, ever under any circumstances, pick up a hitchhiker. Those people out there on the road putting their thumbs out, they ain't what you think, ma'am. They just ain't. Well, but guess what? I'm gonna have a full tank of gas and we won't have no issues then. Know what I mean? Hey, what are you doing? Can I run? Oh, you lucky. Don't touch my car. Alright, let me get my gas. What? No, let me get my gas. I want to get my gas. Please. What was that about? Oh, you see how you try to snatch me up? Ain't no way. Oh wait, he said pump too. Oh my gosh, it's way over there. Okay. We're not gonna check out this smooth driving skill. Watch out. Watch out now. Hit it with the... Show y'all the reverse. You gotta put that arm around your shoulder. Watch me. Get a turn. Then you gotta cut the wheel. Remember, you gotta cut the wheel. Alright, hold on. Look. Cut the wheel. You gotta cut the wheel. Cut it. There we go. Alright. Then you gotta throw the arm back. Look back again. Alright. Get a little forward. Nice. Easy work. What is that? That's how you do it. Alright. My guess. We get 20. Oh wait, hold on, I gotta check my messages. Holly, mom, I don't know if you'll find any shop at this hour, but we're out dog food. You get some, I'll pay you back. Okay, don't do that. I got you, mom. Bro, what's up with this no service? Anyway, dad, it was a lot of messages. Oh, you think I'm going to the convention? They get your car for like 5 days. Eden. It's current time. Ooh, here we go. Now, drive safe, Holly. Where did you reach? Told you to take that flight. Oh, Holly, it's going to be late. You reach back. Hope you're feeling alright. Be alright, Dad. Hey, man, your pops just fear about you, dude. Aiden. Man, y'all were chatting for a minute. Discord. Add me on Discord. I got ticks, so I'll see if I can get the car. Let you know. Finally going to take Milo on a walk. Ella, blah, blah. Get skateboard. Where are you? Almost there. Words, I don't care. Biggest traffic jam of the country. That sucks. Not too good here either. I think it's the people from the convention. That's it, I'm rerouting here. You gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, I understand that, but that's how you get killed. What's wrong with y'all? Anyway, let me grab some dog food real quick. I saw that it said, need some dog food. I need to get by you right there. Is that dog food? I don't know. Oh, I see it. Alright. Thank you. Alright, I need one of these. Alright, appreciate it. Thank you. Alright, let's throw it in the seat. I can just put the intro. Oh, I can put it in the intro? Open it up. Ooh, nice. Ooh. Oh, okay. We got a skateboard. Got some stuff. Sleeping bag. Hat. Toss that in there. Hold on. Put it in there neatly. Nice. This is good. Oh my. Nice. That's what I want. Perfect. Alright, let's go. Yeah. I never played a game where you can open the trunk. I mean, GTA did something like that, but you can actually put something in it. Alright, we're on the road. Yeah, like I was saying, I listen to all the boys. You know a song I've been listening to a lot lately? What's that song called? What's that? Oh, it's called, I guess, Fuck Me by Drake. On the end of that, Heartless. Every single one of them looks like you and me. What is that? Text your mom. Sorry, mom, but I gotta focus on this road. That's what happens. You look at road tip number 456. You don't get your lights checked. Like, what is this? Oh, okay, there we go. But road tip number 457. Never text while driving. Like, I feel like people don't understand when you text and drive, you literally can crash like that. Like, focus. You know? Like, make it make sense. Light shake. I'm assuming our car is going to break down right behind this car. Oh my gosh. This game's... If you haven't noticed, this game's making me extremely nervous. Bro, don't drive off. I need your lights. I can barely see. Can we get something going? Please. Anything? Anything at all? Oh, perfect. Thank you. I was trying to see if I could do anything, because I was just like, bro, turn on the lights. Alright. Woo! Should be easy ride ahead then. Just gotta watch out for the lady in that white dress and we're all good. Seems like we're doing a good job though, 100%, 100%. Just as I said in the last playthrough, I don't go towards the scares. I make sure I stay away from it. There's a reason why you people die in scary movies or horror films and all that. It's because you're following like what they want y'all to do. Like, don't do it. Like, it's obvious that there's somebody here. So why go check that out? Like, leave. You can leave. Call the police. Something. If you're going to go and you have to, take a weapon with you. What are you going in there? Balled up fist. You're not like that. Like, be honest. Your hands are not registered as weapons. Alright. This game's making me nervous. Y'all notice. Bro, I feel like I'm seeing people in the bushes. It's making me, like, extremely nervous and I don't like it. Turn on your lights. Gosh, bro. Are we there yet? Please tell me. I know this is a true story, too, so please tell me you got home. Man. I hope she's alright. I'm assuming it's a she. I hope she's alright. Somebody was parked in that car, but I didn't know one thing. Move, rabbit. Bro, do y'all hear that? Oh my gosh, don't do this right now. Don't do this right now, please. This is a very weird thing about the night. Oh my gosh. Alright, check it out. This is what you do. For tip number 499. You don't panic. You assess the problem and fix it as fast as you can in a timely manner. Do not get caught up in the things that are going on around you. Yo, what is happening? Bro, stay! Get in the car now. I did move the logs. cool. Don't panic. Just get the job done. That's prohibiting you right now. Thank you. All right, let's go. Drive. Dude, you are. Rule number 548. If you ever go long distance, get your car checked before you go, man. Why? Just like that, I'm stranded in the middle of nowhere with no phone service. That's why you get Verizon, dude. I'm not saying that I was running to believe whatever the bull crap that gas station clerk pulled. I would be lying if I say I didn't feel slightest of unease. You think? I don't mean to make this sound like a cliche horror story, but throughout my life I was told not to take ride from strangers. At that moment, I had no choice. I was scared to think how long it would take for me someone to pass who I could not speak just sitting there. Bro. Alright. Man. 10:23 p.m. Oof. Bless your heart. Man. Alright. Oh, you did? Where? Hey! Oh! Bitch? What hit me? Leave another human being stranded like that. I'm gonna be honest. I would've left you too. Like, I'm not here to help you. I'm trying to get home just like you. You ain't hear what the gas station guy said? He said, do not stop when someone's doing this. Get out of there. I'm surprised you haven't got, like, snatched up, honestly. Sir? Is he pulling up? Oh! Perfect. Can I jump? Wish I could run. That'd be nice. No. That'd be a nice feature in the game. I asked him I couldn't run. That would have made things so much easier for me. Just saying. You're the girl from the gas station. Oh, you're the dude that was walking around. Yeah, I didn't think anybody would stop for me. What are you trying to do out here? Say my car just broke down. I can't call for help. There's no phone service. Think I can get a ride? Where you headed? Just near a stop where I can call for help. Yep. Exactly that. Ivan, thanks so much. Could you wait till I get my stuff? Hurry. Just throw it in the back. We'll be here for two. Okay, appreciate you. Oh, I can run now. Nice. Appreciate you, W man. Sorry I spit on him earlier. I'll do it again, but hey, this is. Alright, grab the Hattie. So then I can only carry two at a time because you got two hands. Love it. Let's see it. Anyway, we gotta make haste now. I will say, in this situation, I can't even blame them. They don't really have much of a choice, I guess. So, can I? Well, let me just tell. Let me do this stuff. I don't know. Finally, now hop in. I got you. All right, we're gonna make haste. Let's go. Nice. Big relief. Way to clutch up. Thank you. Hey, you gonna drive? Thank you. Turn on the radio. No? Okay. What's happening? Bumpy road, huh? So you won't tell me who you are, where you're going? Yeah, I'd rather not say it, if that's okay. If you say so. Yeah, I don't know you, dude. Alright, I just need to ride up the road. No, I don't need anything else. Really lucky I had to be on this side of the town tonight. No kidding. I must say, you are one brave young woman. How's that? You got any clue what happened to your car back there? No, honestly, in my opinion, I don't even know what happened, so I don't know. Never broke down on me like that ever before. That statement right there already lets you know. So, the dude at the gas station messed with my car. And I'm blaming you for your car. Dang, he think he's slick. So my dad is pretty old. Yeah. So for real, someone plotting on me. I feel like it's him. Because this is what could have happened. One dude mess up the car, drive off. I go, my car breaks down, and he come by and pick me up. I don't like where this is going. So what do you think about what he told you back at the gas station? It really creeped me out. Like, interesting. Idiot tells that to every person traveling down here. LMB. What does LMB mean? Like my bitch? Like, left. Left mouse click. Oh, hey. Oh, so is it true? What, the monsters? Let's see. I've never seen the monster for myself, but there are some things. And I'm afraid your car breaking down could have been one of them. Hey, listen. I don't want to sound like that moron, but just remember this. You don't bother them and you don't be bothered. Why the statement you said that? Don't know who they is, but I just know they need to leave me alone. Am I right, folks? No, I'm sorry for being a jerk to you before. I'm not the best with people. Okay. Yeah, be better next time. Woo, nice. So is that a story? Easy work. That's what we do. I'm a gamer. I do this. You know what I'm saying? 12:08. Clock strike 9. A little bit of small talk. He dropped me by a motel. Apparently they offer roadside assistance. Besides, I thought I could use a little rest. Be careful. There are all kinds of people out there. He said anonymously before leaving. Okay. Appreciate it. We're at a motel. Man. Oof, I don't know if I'll ever stay in the motels. Motels just seem like bad news right out the gate. So we gotta check in. Yo, I'm here to check in. It was putting out the creepiest vibes imaginable. Bet. Y'all need a room to shack up for the night? What? Yeah, I'm only going to be here for a few hours. $40 for a single. Pay cash only. I got you. Room number 9, right over there. Go. What about my car? $90. Tommy will take care of it next thing in the morning. Nice. Good. I'll let Tommy know. And one last thing. Try not to wake the other guests. They might not take very nicely to it. Okay, I'm trying not to. Am I pressing the wrong button? Thank you. I can run. Nice. Hey, can I get a drink? I'm thirsty. I can get a drink. What are you drinking? Do we have some water? No water? Get lime drink. Can't go wrong with some lime drink. Some of these items are creature. Oh, that's perfect. Hey, why would I need that? Oh, it's gonna be one of those games. I'd be alright. I'm gaming. I can do this. Let's do this. Ooh, look at that speed, y'all. Hold on, let me grab a couple of my things. So I don't have to make the long. Oh, okay. 5 Alright, set in. Oh my, good messages. Alright. Okay, I'm assuming I'm... Oh, you tried to send a message. I'm going to. Dad, we have to stay hotel. Yeah. You gotta do what? Hey, where you at? Your dad's calling me. Ollie? I'm not really saying anything. 11. Nine. Perfect. It was nice and warm. Where's the bed? There's no bed in here. Must be smell like you get from all out. I'm assuming it's one of those ones where you, where you get it out and then... Oh, bitch! Oh my gosh. What are you doing in here? Should be asking you. What were you doing in there? I'm not even reading it. I'm Tommy, room service. You're at a roadway in. Nicest, finest stopover in Norwood. What were you doing in there? You know, cleaning stuff. Okay. Got the front desk, gave me this room. I'm gonna have to ask you to step outside while I make the room. I'll just keep the stuff. Yeah, you need to, like, bro, what are you doing? That speed up? There we go, I'm lightning. I am speed. I am lightning. Ah. You need something? Had a word with Joe about the situation. What's wrong with these people? Mercy, mercy, mercy. What are you talking about? Oh, somebody messed with my car, so okay. That's what I thought. But don't you worry. Safe here. I'll go get your car. And also, the room's phone is not working. Need anything, just ask at the front desk. We've been trying to get it fixed, but we haven't been seeing enough guests lately. But you have a good night. Appreciate it. Just don't. I still think it's creepy that you were just standing in the bathroom like a like dude was just standing there. Like, bro, like, ooh. Jeez. Cat got your tongue? Hey, I'm gonna file some charges on your boy, just so you know. And like how he was looking at me. Come on, real quick. What? Yeah. Oof, they're really making you work for this, huh? Alright, we can go ahead and throw this on the side and hit day and call it a day. Get on home. Is that all you got, game? That's why I'm the MVP. The GOAT. The GOAT. I hear it, I hear it. Assuming I could peek through blinds in this game. Matter of fact, oh, he's right here. Just so I can peek through those blinds much easier. Okay, that can stay right there. Crouch. Well, it's not my first time playing on PC, but it's like, I've been playing on PC few times this month for the first time, and I'd say it's very nerve-wracking. Very nerve-wracking. Alright, let's go to bed. I don't like that closet is open though. Is that somebody? Place. Couldn't help shake the feeling that something wasn't right. And the tiredness was overcoming by anxiety. Hot cup of coffee couldn't help. I thought to myself, oh, okay. Wait, that machine didn't have coffee. Thought it might have been Oh, I gotta move this out of the way. Bro, there was somebody at that window. I know there was. Alright, first off, I'm just gonna close this just in case. Okay, there's nothing in this room. Close that. Bunch of corners. Alright, I need... There was a machine next to it. Maybe over there? No. Maybe I just missed it. No, I'm not seeing no copy. Maybe over here? Perfect. Well, I don't know how much it was, but hopefully it's good for the soul. These items help you stay awake. Well, why are we trying to stay awake? Are we trying to get some sleep? What is happening? Oh, whoa, controls backwards. Okay, I did this. Come on, just make it to your room. Get to safety. Get your key out, get it ready to unlock the door, get in there. Perfect. Remember, controls are backwards. Close the door. There we go. That's nasty. Yuck. 3:18 a.m. Man, I was sedated. Are you all right? Wait, I thought the phone line wasn't working. Wait, did somebody just go in the closet? I saw that. Somebody's in my closet. I know y'all saw that. Somebody's in my closet. I'm getting out of the room now. You feel safe in here? Oop. Somebody's in that closet. I saw somebody go in that closet. Oh, it's the manager. Hey. There's somebody in here. I specifically told you not to wake anyone. Forget that! There's somebody in my room! I have complaints. What are you making all those goofy... I don't even care what you're saying. Are your eyes already... The coffee! I got sedated by that thing. Are you messing with me? No. No, I haven't...
Oh my gosh!
There's no way this happened. It's right over there. Yeah, show them. Yeah, I've had enough of crazy goons here for once. I thought we had a sober guest, but I guess I'm crazy. Hate my job. Come here, Joe. First off, there's somebody in there. So first, we're closing this door. Joe, close the door. Thank you. Joe, check me out, Joe. There's somebody in that room. But first, I'm going to show you this coffee machine because I'm assuming that that's what this game wants me to do. But once you see this coffee machine, I want you to call the police or handle that. Bro, there's a fly in here. But for real though, I want you to handle that. There's a fly in my room. Oof. Alright, so the coffee machine. Wait, where's the coffee machine? Yo! I swear, I said go back now. Okay? Should be some medication in your room. I should offer you some relief. Bro, I can't go back in that room. Hit the table by the TV. Bro, there's somebody in there. They're really making me go back in here. Yo, there's no way. You were in there? You went back in this room while he was in there? You didn't see. No way. I'm giving myself room to run. He's in there. I know he is. Is that open? It is. He left. Is he in? Oh, I can't open. Fuck it, I ain't gonna open it then. Out of sight, out of mind. That's what I live by. I'm trying to close the door. Requires water. What do you need? Some water. Ugh, jeez. Wake up cancer, baby. Nice. Yo. He's in there. Yo, I'm trying to help you out, but the way you operate right now isn't helping. Okay. I guess we're just gonna have to sleep this off, I guess. There's a creep in the room. Oh my gosh. Alright, I'm assuming there's nothing else I need to do. There's something I'm supposed to do. Doesn't seem like it. Yo. Oh, it's just a residence. Oh, wait, no, that's somebody coming up to my door. Can I hide? Can I hide? Oh my gosh, that is nasty. I can't hide. Get out of the fucking bed right now. That is nasty. There's two people in here. Can I hide in here? Oh
my gosh, there's a sound thing in here.
There's a sound thing in this game. Who is it? Please open the door. I need your help. Nah. What do you want? I need your help, please. If you can't explain it, you don't need my help. Bud. I know you're in there. Yeah, leave. I just need to talk to you. I swear I'm not a cop. Go away, like, pretty lady. Oh! Go, 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 go. Crouch. The sound. Oh my gosh, my microphone almost got me killed. To this day, I find it really weird that, bro, my microphone almost got me killed. Manager, prefer not to get police involved as it would affect the motel's revenue. And forget that, call them. I believe that the town could have been home to a cult or a drug ring, or possibly something even worse. Tommy arrived with the car after what felt like a year. I never went on long road trips again. I will always take airplanes. Good for you, man. Jeez. Oh my gosh. Whew. That's another one, folks. Oh my gosh. And with that, folks, that is the end of Here's to Fathom episode 2. Jeez. Oh my gosh. I still can't believe that these are like actual stories. Like, oh, couldn't be me, man. Because I'm, as you can tell, I stay at home all the time. Never gonna put myself in a predicament like that. Y'all are soldiers. Just want to mention I appreciate every single one of y'all coming in, watching these videos, hoping that y'all really do like them. And for the new people that are here, be sure to check out my other videos. I really appreciate that. And with that, y'all have a lovely day. Peace.